Hello friends, we are bigdatahandsome.com. Today is day 22. We are going to see naive Bayes theorem. And our website bigdatahandsome.com. You can visit our website. If you have any doubts, you can message us in this number 9789884, or you can send email through support@bigdatahandsome.com. And previously upload taken sessions. Will be uploaded in our YouTube channel bigdatahandsome.com. If you subscribe to our channel, you will get all the notifications. So today is a naive Bayes theorem. So let's jump into our today's topic. Okay, so naive Bayes is a probabilistic machine learning algorithm that can be used in a wide variety of classification tasks. So we already know, like in high secondary school, we have studied a theorem, Bayes theorem, right? This is a probability theorem. So based on the probability theorem, we created a naive Bayes, an algorithm in machine learning. So why it is called naive? So it's called naive is because it assumes that all the variables, input variables, are independent, and it's an unrealistic assumption for real data. But these naive Bayes work in a large range of data also. So uses of naive Bayes is spam filtering, classifying documents, and sentiment analysis. Like that, we'll use naive Bayes. So today, the example will be spam filtering based using the naive Bayes algorithm. Okay, so first we need to know what is the Bayes theorem, right? To know what's the Bayes theorem, the basic is the probability. So start with probability. So what is probability? So you know that, for example, in case of you're tossing a coin, so the probability of getting head is 0.5. Why? Is because so head is only one there. So what is the available actions, available results? That is head and tail. Two options we have, two results we can come. In that two results, head is only one, so that's why 1/2. Okay, and the 1/2 is 0.5. This is the probability of getting head. The same for probability of getting tail also. So in case of your rolling a dice with six faces we have, so in that six faces, what is the probability of getting a four? So in that six faces, only one four is there, so 1/6. Okay, so the probability is 0.166. okay, it's a basic one, we know that. And now we have a probability of conditional probability. So that means we need to find the probability of something based on the condition it's provided. For example, here, what's the probability of getting a queen given that the card is spade? Okay, so that means it comes queen bar spade. It means we need to calculate the probability of queen. The queen card is spade. Okay, so it's 1/13. How this 1/13 is, we expanded here like this. So probability of queen and spade, and divided by probability of spade. Okay, so probability of queen and spade card, one in 52 cards, only one card is queen and spade both. And divided by probability of spade means, in the 52 cards, we have 13 cards that is spade cards, right? So now the probability will be 1/52 divided by 13/52. We can eliminate the 52. So on the final is 1/13. Okay, so the 1/13 would be 0.077. So that's what the probability of queen that the card is spade. Okay, so an example of the conditional probability. So the school example. So here we have this table, count table. So we have a teacher and student in the school. So they are female or male. Okay. So total number of teachers are 20. Total number of students are 80. So female are 40 and male are 60. Okay. So based on this count, we are going to find that a teacher, the given that he is a male. Okay. So that probability will be teacher and male divided by probability of male, right? So the teacher and male, how many count are there? Teacher and male. So just 12 teachers, they are male. Okay. And probability of male will be, the count of male is 60. Okay, right? So and then the probability will be 12 by 60. Okay. So the probability is 0.2. So likewise, we have a two different equations, like probability of A given B or B given A. Okay. If that probability of A given B, then it would be probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. If in the case of probability of B given A, look at the denominator, it is changing, right? So if A given B, then the B is coming in the denominator. If B given A, then A comes in the denominator. Okay. So using this equation, we are going to create an Bayes or naive Bayes algorithm. Okay. So the Bayes rule is, the Bayes rule is a way to go from probability of X given Y to find probability of Y given X. So that means X given Y means we are given the outcome already. We know the outcome. So that's the training data, right? So in training data, all the data is labeled. But if you want to predict something, if you want to test the model, we don't give the dependent features, right? We don't give the outcome. We'll only give the evidences, the independent variables, okay? So we need to find, we are going to predict the outcome, the given evidence, right? So that's what the Y bar X is. It's unknown because we're going to find the Y, it's our outcome, given evidence, okay? It's the test data, right? So that's outcome bar evidence. Okay. So the final equation will be Bayes rule, that is Y given X equal to probability of X given Y multiplied by probability of Y divided by probability of X. This was the Bayes rule is. And now using this, we're going to convert for is actually a single feature. We have X here. We have a single independent variable, single dependent variable. What about multiple variables we are going to give, input variables, right? So in that time, the Bayes rule is formed, the naive Bayes is formed. So when there are multiple X variables, we simplify it by assuming the X are independent. That's why it's called naive Bayes, okay? So the Bayes rule becomes probability of Y equal to K bar X. That is, K is nothing but the classes. For example, in Y, it can have classes like 0 or 1, male or female, or it can be a fruits, right? So the K is the classes. Okay, bar X is the given variables. Okay, and now the probability of, we know that the probability of X given Y equal to K multiplied by probability of Y equal to K divided by probability of X. Okay, so that's why I said the K is a class. Okay. Okay, becomes naive Bayes. So we convert this Bayes rule to naive Bayes, it becomes like this. So we may have multiple X variables. For multiple variables, X variables, see here, like X1 to XN. So for X1 to X1, we do this step here. Like probability of X1 given Y equal to K, and then probability of X2 given Y equal to K. Like that, we have probability of XN given Y equal to K. And in the denominator also, we have probability of X1 into probability of X2 till probability of xn. But this denominator is excluded with, because it's a constant actually. For every class, this denominator will be a constant, right? That's why we exclude this one, this part, the denominator part. Let's see some examples, the working examples of naive bias. So say you have 1,000 fruits. 1 minute. Me. So you have 1,000 fruits, which could be either banana, orange, or other. So we have three classes now. Using we are going to predict these three classes given 1,000 fruits. Okay, these are the okay, these are the three possible classes of y variable. So now we have data for the following x variables. So these are the x variables we have: long, sweet, yellow. So the fruit can be long or short, it can be sweet or non-sweet, or it can be yellow or other colors, right? So we put a 0 and 1 there, because if it is a fruit is long, we put 1, otherwise we put 0. If the fruit is sweet, we put 1, otherwise 0. So like that, if the fruit is yellow, we put 1, otherwise 0, right? So like that, we'll create a data set like this. So fruit is orange, banana, or other. We have three features: long, sweet, yellow. So you can see the orange fruit is not long, so we put 0 there. Banana is long, so we put 1 there. So like that, orange is sweet, we put 1. So banana for 0. Orange is not orange, that's why we put 0 here in yellow column. So banana is yellow fruit, so we put 1 there. Like this, the data is we have. So now we are going to create a count table using this data. So this is the count table now. So we have banana, total banana fruits are 500. You can see orange, total orange fruits are 300. Other, we have total 200 other fruits. Okay, now we have two columns, right? Long and not long. So we have two classes here for variable x1. We have two class 0 and 1. So we are creating columns for 0 and for 1 also. That's why long and not long. So here now, so total long fruits are 500, total not long fruits are 500, sweet fruits 650, not sweet 350, yellow fruits are 800, not yellow fruits are 200. That's what the count table is now. So using this count table, we're going to predict is the given fruit is long, sweet, and yellow. Okay, what is the fruit? Here it is. The question is here. You can see if a fruit is long, sweet, and yellow, what fruit is it? Okay, so we know that that's banana, but this we are going to derive it from the naive Bayes theorem. Okay, okay, so calculations, we need the probability of banana, orange, and other. Okay, so for every k actually, now y equal to banana. So we have total 500 banana fruits over 10,000 fruits, right? So the probability is 0.5. And then for orange also, orange we have 300 fruits over 1,000 fruits, we have 0.3 is the probability of orange. And then the probability of other is 0.2. okay, so we'll calculate that the probabilities. Now we need to calculate the likelihood for banana. This is the same for for orange and other also. So let's calculate the likelihood for banana. So we have three features, right? X1, X2, X3. Okay, so we will calculate each and every features. So X1 long and banana, we have 400 long fruits are banana, right? So 400 divided by 500. 500 is because total we have 500 long fruits, right? That's why. And that the probability is 0.80. Like that for every feature, sweet feature and yellow feature. So we got probabilities like 0.8, 0.7 and 0.9. So the overall probability of likelihood of banana is evidence of for banana. So we multiply the probabilities, right? In the equation, you can see we are multiplying the probabilities, right? Here you can see we are multiplying the probabilities, and we are multiplying the probability of the class, the banana class. And after the final step, we'll calculate this here. So here we'll calculate. Now, if a fruit is long, sweet and yellow, what fruit is it? So we are going to calculate the probability of banana and the probability of orange and probability of other fruit, okay? With the, and given these features, okay? Okay, now we have already calculated the probabilities for banana, the evidences. So the probabilities we know that 0.8, 0.7, 0.9. And the probability of banana is 0.5, okay? And we multiply this nominator, and that is 0.252. This is the probability for banana given these features. Now we'll calculate the probability of orange given these features. This 0, because we know that that's not long fruit, that means the probability will become 0. If you multiply it 0, all the values will be 0. That's why the value is 0 here. And for other fruit is 0.01875. It's very less than when compared to the probability of banana. So we end up with the result. The highest probability is for banana only. So the answer for this question, if a fruit is long, sweet and yellow, what is fruit is? It is a banana, okay? This is how the naive bias will work. So we give the features, and it will predict the probabilities for the class, and it will give the result which has the highest probability, right? So the final equation will be like this. So we, actually we have the argmax, that means we give the maximum result. So argmax of probability of y, and then pi probability of xi bar y. And some multiplication, we'll multiply these steps I equal to 1 to n features. Okay, now let's see the implementation. Now let me open Spider. Okay, for I said I'm going to demonstrate you the spam filtering, right? So the data set source is Kaggle. Go to Kaggle, and in the data sets you can find here in the data, just type spam filtering. Okay, here we need to type spam filtering, or just so this data set has only two columns, the message and the label. Okay, so I think you can use this one also, but I have a different data set. The label will be spam and ham, nothing different. Okay, so we have two columns. This one is the message, and this one is the label. If it is spam, it would be 1, otherwise it's 0. Okay. Using the data set, you are going to predict whether the message is spam or not. Okay. Now let me create a file and let's save this file. Actually, now we are working with a different data, right? So we have the message. We don't have any columns that are independent features. We have only a message. We are going to convert this message to independent features, but we don't know how to pre-process the texts, right? We have only seen the pre-processing. We have only seen filling the NaN values, like converting the categorical into numericals. But what about text? So we'll see tomorrow. See, we'll see now. So the first step would be processing the text right here. So processing the text. So we have for that we have a library, NLTK. So let me first import the pandas numpy libraries. Pandas and numpy, and read the data set data equal to wait. So we have the spam data here. It's a little bit different actually. Same thing, the label is not labeled actually. Here the class is not labeled. We have ham or spam like that. No problem, it would work without labeling actually. Okay, let me read the data. Data equal to pd dot read csv dataset slash spam dot csv. Actually, we need to give the encode here for this file only, not for other, not for all files. This file is encode off. Encoding is Latin one, so don't worry about that. Okay, now we got the data frame here. So this is the data frame. So we have two columns. The first one is the label ham and spam, and the next one is the message column. So forget these three columns. Okay, so this one is the y variable, and these are the x variables, right? So we'll separate the data into x and y. So the second column is for x. So we take all the rows, but the second column, the index for second column is 1, because the index starts from 0, you know that. And for y is the dot I log. It is the 0 index, because the first column. Okay. So in the X, you can see the messages here, and in the Y, we have the labels spam, ham. Okay. Let me close this. Okay. So now we got the data. Here in the X feature, we have the text here, right? So we need to know how to pre-process the texts. So we have some pre-processing steps for that. Like the first step, what we do is we'll remove the stop words, and we'll remove the punctuations, and we'll lemmatize that. I will tell you what is lemmatize. And the fourth step will be removing some digits in the text, removing digits. And the fifth one be removing some extra spaces there, removing extra spaces. Okay, this five step will follow. The first step it stop words, and then punctuations and lemmatizing and removing digits, removing extra spaces. So for this I will first import the libraries which it's needed for these steps. The first one is NLTK. Actually NLTK, in the NLTK we need to import the lemmatizer, that is inside the stem dot net, sorry, wordnet, import wordnet lemmatizer. This class we want for lemmatizing these steps. And we want a class that's inside the sklearn dot text extraction, sorry, feature extraction, that is feature extraction dot text, import the count vectorizer. This class is used to convert text into the features, number of features. For example, the count vectorizer, what it will do, it will count the go. Okay, so how many times the go is occurred or not, how many times the until is occurred or not. So like we are created in this example, I have shown you the count table, right? Here's the count table. So like this count table we can create using the count vectorizer. This count vectorizer actually used for that purpose, creating the count table. And then I'm going to import from the NLTK dot corpus import the stop words. Oh sorry, NLTK dot corpus dot stop, I think. Import stop words. I think only corpus only, I think. NLTK dot corpus, yes. And then we need the punctuations. It can be imported with string, actually. String library we have. String. Okay. Now first let me create the variable for punctuations. It has the set of punctuations string dot punctuation here. Okay, this variable contains all the punctuation characters. And now we create a variable for stop. This variable contains the list of stop words, stop words dot words of English words. Okay, and then we create a object for lemmatizer called as lemmatizer. lemmatizer equal to ordinate lemmatizer. Okay. So let's run this. Actually, you need to import, you need to download two things. That is here in the error, you can see that. It will show error. The error is, you can see, stopwatch is not there. So you need to download that via these two lines. Import NLTK. Type import NLTK. And then nltk.download stopwatch. Okay, that's it. Now run this again. Okay, now we got all these variables. Now it's time to create a function. For example, I'm going to create a function called clean. It will clean the text here. The given text, it will clean the text using the puncture. It will remove the punctuation, stop words. Okay, now let's see the list of punctuations. You can see, so these are the punctuation characters. We'll remove these characters from the message, from the text, and then the stop words. You can see these are the list of stop words. We'll remove these words all from the text also. Okay, so now we created a function called clean. It will clean the text. So first let me create a variable t, and this t contains the cleaned, or you can say this contains the stop words removed characters. Okay, so I'm going to create a list, and this list, for example, will have the I for, this is the list comprehension actually, for I in text dot lower. We'll convert all the text into lower and split the text based on the space. Okay, and then we'll put a condition. The condition is, I'm going to check the letter, the word that's not in the stop words. So for example, if the in I, let's say there is in, okay, in or is. So we'll check the in or is, whether that is inside the stop words or not. If not, then you can add in this list. Otherwise, don't add this in this list. Remove the character like that. So we'll put a condition. If I not in stop words, not in the stop words. So this is the condition now. So now finally it contains the words that are not stop words. Okay, stop words removed characters will be here in the T. And now the second step, what we'll do again, we'll do join, and now we're going to remove the punctuation characters. So same I for I in not the text dot lower, we'll take this one. Actually, now we have removed the stop words, so we'll take the list of words after remove the stop words, and then we'll remove the punctuations. So for I in t, if I not in punctuation. Okay, and then the third step will be, we're going to lemmatize that. Okay, join lemmatizer dot lemmatize the character I for I in t. Okay, for I in t. So now we lemmatize that, and then what we are going to do is, we are going to remove some extra spaces and digits. So here we will do import re regular expression, and now the text will be re dot sub. Re dot sub. If you have more than one spaces, what's this? So we'll get a raw string, and here we'll put slash d plus. That means we're going to substitute space to the digits. If you have a more digits here like this, then we put a space in the data t. Okay, now and then again we'll do for, sorry, this actually re, not rs, and then for re dot sub. Now we are going to remove the extra spaces, that is slash s plus. It's for extra spaces, and we'll put space. Okay, this was the pre-processing steps for text. Now after this we'll return the pre-processed text t. Okay, so now we have the function. Now what we are going to do is, for every text in the x here, for every line, so we give the line to the function clean, and it will give you the cleaned text, and then we'll update this text. So like that we'll do for every messages here. So what we're going to do is, we'll run a loop for I in range of length of the x. Okay, for length of the x we'll do, and here what we need to do is, we're going to assign the x of i equal to, we're going to update the text, right? So clean of x of i. Okay, right, so take that message in the x of i, and then clean it, and then update the x of i. That's it. Okay, now let's run this. Okay, another one. So you can see now we don't have the wordnet. Okay, we don't download that wordnet. So let's download this. Okay, now we got the cleaned text right here. So you can see upper cases are also converted into lower cases. The punctuations are removed, extra spaces are removed, digits are removed, right? So now we have only the characters only, right? So now we are going to convert into a count table. Okay, for every characters, for every words, we'll count it. How many go word is there? How many times this character, this word is there? So like that we'll count it using the class count vectorizer. So we need to create a object for vectorizer, a count vectorizer. For example, vectorize, let's say. So we call the class count vectorizer. Okay, so now we call the class, and then what we'll do, we'll fit into the x data. So x equal to vectorizer dot fit underscore transform, right? Fit transform of the x data. So now if you run these two lines, you will get a large data, vectorized data you will get. We can't visualize that data actually, it is very large actually. So you can see here the size, you can see 5572 cross 8532. This size the data is now. Okay, so now what you can do is you can do vectorizer. If you want to see the words vocabulary which are used in the vectorizer, so vocabulary is nothing but the words are used in the texts. So you can see vocabulary here, vocabulary underscore. So these are the words and the count, how many times times the word occurs. So you can see, right, this is the vocabulary now. Okay, so now what we are going to do is, now we got the data pre-processed, now it's time to split the data set into training and testing, right? So we'll import the train test split function, sklearn dot model selection, import the train test split. Okay, this will return four values, xtrain, xtest, ytrain, ytest. Okay, call the function and give the data x and y, and test size is 0.25 and random state will be 0. Let's take it as 0. Now let's run these two lines. So after getting the training data, it's time to build the model. So for every model we have a class in the sklearn. For namespace also we have the classes in the sklearn module, sklearn library. Inside we have a module called namespace. Inside the namespace we have the algorithms for namespace. So you can see we have multiple algorithms for namespace: Gaussian NB, multinomial NB, Bernoulli NB, complement, and these are the functions which we use for different types of data. So like for example, let's say Bernoulli data, Bernoulli NB. So Bernoulli NB is used when you have only two input features, or you can say two classes like 0 and 1. So we use that if you have Bernoulli NB. This Gaussian NB, when you have for example too many classes you have, then it will use like continuous classes. If you have, you can use the Gaussian NB. Which the multinomial NB which we are going to use is used when you have multiple features, multiple X features that are considered independent. Okay, so this multinomial NB is built up with this equation. So we have seen, right, the equation, the final equation, and this one, the probability argmax of probability of y. Okay, the multinomial NB is using this equation only. Okay, that's why we are using the multinomial NB, because we have the count table, right? So when you have a count table for your features, you can use multinomial namespace. Okay, so let's create the object classifier multinomial NB. Okay, now we need to fit the classifier into the data set. X underscore train comma y underscore train. Now we have fitted the data set. So you can see namespace work with a large range of data, right? So Naive Base, you can work with easily. You can work with Naive Base when you have large data also. Okay, now we have fitted the data set into training. Now let's predict the testing data. Classifier dot predict. Okay, could not convert string to float. Right. Oh, we forgot to that, right? Okay. We need to convert label encode that. Expected 2D array got 1D array instead. Input operand 1 has a mismatch in its code dimension. What? These problems we didn't face previously. Previously we doesn't did this actually. You can see okay. This was the problem is right. It's a silly mistake is you can see I predicted the white test. That's what the problem is actually. We give the X test, right? Okay. Okay, now it's working. The mistake is I just put a Y test here in the predict. So that must be X test, right? Okay, now we got the test results. Let's open the Y pred. So you can see harm and spam is there. Actually, this algorithm will work without labeling this the class actually. I got surprised when I see the error actually. That's what it is. Okay. So now, let's put a classification confusion matrix table to know the accuracies. So matrix import confusion matrix. Thank you. this the correct predictions 1172 plus 185 the correct predictions, and 12 plus 24 is 36 are incorrect predictions totally. Okay, so now the if you want to see the accuracy score of that, you can simply say classifier dot score of the x test data and y test data. So now the score is, you can see it's giving a high accuracy, right? 0.97, 97% accuracy the naive Bayes is giving when you have a large range of data also. Okay, this is how the naive Bayes is worked. Okay, you have any doubts? We'll end up the session from this. Any doubts? Any doubts? We'll end up the session. Otherwise, okay. I hope no doubts. So we are bigdatahandson.com. Our website bigdatahandson.com. You can visit our website. Our number is contact number, you can see in the top bar, 9799844. If you have any doubts, you can message us in this number, or you can send email through support@bigdatahandson.com. So our previously taken videos is uploaded in our YouTube channel, bigdatahandson.com. So you can see until the random forest, yesterday we took random forest. Until random forest, we have uploaded the videos. So you can see the videos. If you subscribe to our channel, you get all the notifications. Okay, so let's meet tomorrow. Tomorrow will be support vector machine and kernel SVM. Okay, so we'll see tomorrow. Bye.